Welcome to the nightmare.
Trevor, hey, let's take a peek in the backpack.
You got a problem, cuz?
Yeah, your reputation. Well, let's see the backpack.
The mad farmer.
You open any schools lately?
You have to go through an X-ray every morning.
If I were you, trash can, I want to be caught in the men's room.
Oh, excuse me.
Later, dork.
Congratulations. You're the first casualty of zero tolerance.
Okay, everyone, listen up. I said listen up. Any suspicion of violence, physical or verbal, will result in immediate suspension or expulsion. That is zero tolerance. All right, come on, move on through.
Mr. Adams, let's talk in my office before homeroom.
Trevor, how was your summer?
Oh, just wonderful.
Trevor, put the camera away, please.
What made it wonderful?
Well, between counseling and having to repeat my courses in summer school, it's a toss-up.
You know, Trevor, a lot of parents call for your expulsion. But Mr. Olson and others supported your reinstatement.
If you would be so kind as to provide me with a list of their names, I'd like to send thank you cards.
Why are you here, Trevor?
Well, my parents pay taxes, which entitles them to one free public education.
I'd like to continue anger management with you, but it's your call. You know, maybe I can help you through the tough spots.
Say hey to him.
Hell no, man. He might blow me up.
He's one of us, man.
He's too cool.
We are going to start with a broad survey of American literature. Hawthorne, Poe, Twain, and James. Pass these back. Mr. Adams.
Poe, Twain, James, Mr. Adams.
I doubt what you're listening to is going to help you on the SATs, Mr. Adams.
Found the pyramids, Mr.
Almost. Well, my calf muscle halfway up, man.
What should we go for, Mr. D? Isn't it just a staircase?
Yeah, eight stairs, 6 feet high. Oh. That's what I said. Oh.
Hey, Trevor. Wait up.
Hey, see you again. How's it going?
Summer school, bummer school.
Hey, listen, they screw up your schedule. I got you in my video class, but not in drama.
Yeah, I'm done with theater.
No, when you change your mind, there's always a drama club, right?
How's the mad bomber?
Come on, you know better. It was just a phase.
Oh, yeah, I remember when I went through that, the teenage terrorist phase.
Downloading a terrorist cookbook, making bombs, trying to blow up my school.
There was no real bomb.
Yeah, the only thing it didn't have was an explosive.
Well, you made a mistake. He needs a second chance.
Look in that kid's eyes. I swear I can hear him tick.
Where's your ring?
The engagement's off.
Oh. Oh. It's off. Ah. Well, I'm sorry.
Don't drown in your crocodile tears.
Oh, excuse me. You can't just sit where you want.
Why not?
Who are you with?
With?
You have to be varsity or a cheerleader to sit at this table.
Or know everybody.
That table's for the druggies, stoners, deadheads, burnouts, and the hippies.
That one, preppies. Then you have the skateboarders and skateboard chicks, the nerds and techies. Up against the wall, the wiggers, hip-hoppers, rednecks, goths, and all manner of freaks, troublemakers, losers, sluts, gays, floaters, and the trogs.
Trogs?
Troglodytes.
Freakiest of the freaks. Where do you sit if you just want to have lunch?
Hey, I'm Brad. Do you want to sit with me?
No, thanks.
Hey, good going last year.
What?
You're standing up to them. You want to sit with us?
No, thanks.
That's cool, man.
I got this play off the internet. I really like this play.
I really want to do this play.
I want you to play the main character.
You're joking.
I'm not joking.
I'm not getting up in front of these people.
Why not?
Give them another reason to trash me? I don't think so.
Will you at least read the play?
That's the point.
Hey, what did you want to see me for?
Hi, Jenny. Jenny.
Hi.
Jenny just moved here from California. Saw her some regionals last year. Awesome. Awesome, Juliet. To be reading Katie, the female lead.
Well, maybe it wouldn't hurt to read it.
Yeah. Well, I'm on lunch duty. Let me know what you think.
You mind if I sit here?
Lots of room.
So I was just given an education on the pecking order here. So what's your classification in the hierarchy?
Pariah.
So how'd you get to be a pariah?
Well, you gotta make up your mind and persevere.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Well, you get the whole table to yourself.
Pariahs have good perks.
So you wanna read the play together after school?
Yeah.
Your video must be no longer than 10 minutes. It must have a beginning, a middle, and an end, and... it is due in 3 weeks. If you start now, you'll have plenty of time. Remember, I want you to give free rein to your imagination. Explore a fantasy, whatever that means to you. Go outside the box. Let the video camera become an extension of your mind. Boys, be nice to the girls and vice versa.
See you later. Be good. No.
Okay. Why not?
This year's gonna be hard enough.
Okay. But, Trevor, why don't you decide who you are before someone else does?
You should be more careful about the company you keep.
Pardon me?
That guy you ate lunch with, nobody goes near him.
Break it off if you know it's good for
you. If you want any friends in this school.
What that guy knows can kill you.
I don't get Josh at all.
What, do you mean like killing kids?
No, I get that part. I just don't know how you can kill the girl that you love.
Well, but didn't he feel betrayed by her?
Yeah, sure.
Well, have you ever felt like that?
Do you know anything about me?
Well, kids say some stuff.
What stuff?
Some crazy stuff about you threatening to explode the football team.
It's true.
How did you get to that place?
You ever been low?
Like depressed? Well,
I mean, sometimes. But I mean, I don't think about exploding football teams.
Jenny, I don't mean depressed like your dog died. I mean where you feel that you have got nothing to lose, where you don't care if you live or die. That kind of depressed? You ever been there?
No.
Okay, well, I have.
Well, it seems like you've done your homework for the play.
I don't think you're going to get into the cool cliques if you're seen hanging out with me.
Well, then maybe we should make our own clique.
Hey, Mr. D.
Hey, Trevor.
She's a trip.
Yes, she is.
So I was thinking I'd like to give the play a shot.
Really? Wow. Gosh, Trevor.
Yeah.
You know, I wish you got a hold of me sooner because, you see, I already cast someone.
Okay. Can I help you?
Excuse me, is there a problem?
I'd rather go elsewhere.
I wonder how much business I'm losing because of you. Work in the back.
Trevor, how was your day?
Video class was cool.
And?
And people stared. They went through my bag twice. Somebody went through my locker.
Well, you gotta pay the price.
I think it'll just take time before people will trust you again.
They want me to do a play.
Trevor, that's great.
Yeah, but rehearsals are after school.
So. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I need you at the cleaners after school. That's my busy time.
Well, maybe I could fill in for Trevor.
How can you do that?
I don't know. I can juggle my schedule at the bank.
And we have to eat even later?
Forget it. Okay?
He has got to get back into the swing of things.
So he does a play and gets out of his car. What does that mean?
This is what it would look like if I put my head in the stove.
Yeah.
This for future reference, it might be kind of cool. I mean, my highs compared to my lows are 1 in a million. I mean, that's it. That's not true. I mean, that's an exaggeration. More like, you know, 1 in like 500.
Hey, Trevor, let's have a look in that backpack.
Singing Jingle Bells, you're gonna be hurt. You're gonna be hurt. You're gonna be hurt.
Move on, move on.
That'll settle the score. Hell, becoming a martyr, you know? Going down and teaching these bastards a lesson can definitely wrap my head around it.
And this?
That was the time I ran away from home.
Ah, Peace Corps? Save the world?
Actually, the world saved me.
Yes?
Oh, a little play I did off-off-Broadway. One reviewer commented that I perform it off-off-off-off-off-Broadway, so here I am.
And that?
One man show in Seattle. Reviews like my mother wrote them, so they got a star. Took it to New York. They all made a lot of money. More wine?
You know, you're the hot topic in the teacher's lounge.
Is that right?
They all wonder why you've cast the mad bomber as a cold-blooded murderer in Bang Bang, You're Dead Meat.
Bang Bang? Bang Bang, You're Dead. And I don't think calling the mad bomber is that helpful. You know, if you could have known Trevor before all this, this is the kind of kid you got into teaching for.
He said Don Quixote.
He's the most honest kid I've ever worked with.
Honest? Are you talking about the same kid?
Oh, that's good. Hoi. It's garlic bread flambé. My specialty. All right, let's jump in. Josh, deceased. Up on stage, please. What we're gonna do here is we're not gonna worry about the words. We're just gonna get to the rhythm. Starting with Josh. It's okay to be nervous. And.
Who's there? Okay. So I'm in jail, and these are the kids that I killed earlier today.
Correct.
So, obviously, the play takes place in my head.
If I have deceased, it figments your imagination.
If they're in my head, why am I talking to them?
Ah.
So, the whole play is in my head.
Ah.
So I'm obviously wrestling with my conscience.
Ah.
Why would I conjure them up if I know they're only going to torment me?
Let's talk about your triggers. You know, things that set you off. By recognizing the trigger, you can stop it before it gets you into trouble. So come on, tell me something that really ticks you off.
That's hard.
Mm-hmm. I know. Just...
Because I just love everyone.
This isn't gonna work unless you open up, okay?
Open up so you can use it against me?
If you don't want to talk, then you can use this time to study.
Thank you much.
Squirm, it's killing me not to tell.
So to tell you.
You got it?
Okay. Pizza after school.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
What are you doing? I don't think I want the camera on anymore. We have work to do. Come on. Come on.
Josh, there's no way we're buying you a rifle.
Mom, will you listen to me?
First you had to have a PC, then every video game ever made, and a laptop.
For school, Dad.
Hey, jog it off the gate to school.
You wanted to see me?
Yeah, sure, I'll have a seat.
About a kid who commits a mass murder, I will pull my boy out of school.
Miss
Myers, my daughter tells me she's in a play called Bang Bang You're Dead. I can't fathom why you would...
Hi, this is Police Chief Bud McGee. I'm calling to inquire about a rumor of a play at your school about a kid killer.
I get the point.
There's more. Much more. And none of it good.
Have you even read it?
I don't need to. The title alone could spark the powder keg that we're sitting on.
This place had thousands of productions.
When a school installs an $11,000 metal detector at its front door, it can't turn around and do a play called Bang Bang You Die.
Bang Bang You're Dead. What would you suggest? Maybe we should do Romeo and Juliet? Two teenagers commit suicide?
Touché, Val. Let's find some more suitable entertainment.
You don't really mean that.
Hey, we're rehearsing.
Sorry, guys. We're signing up for this room at 4 o'clock.
Yeah, well, it's not time, so shut the door.
You have 3 minutes.
Make it 5. You interrupted us.
Okay.
For school, Dad.
The newest talent Nike's ever seen, man.
Let's just rehearse someplace else.
I don't know what your problem is, dude, but you don't scare me.
Dad, you know what my problem is? This is a theater rehearsal room. We can't do a play on a football field, can we?
We're rehearsing the pep rally.
Really? That's neat.
Just relax.
Hey. Are you messing with Trev again? Next time you get launched.
I like to see how bad you talk when you're alone, headcase.
Yeah, we don't have numbers on our backs. It doesn't mean we don't play hard.
Why wait?
Hey, Trevor. We're going.
Ammonium nitrate.
What?
Kerosene, fuse, match, boom.
I'm real scared, trash can.
The walls cold and pale, the cage made of steel. Screams fill the room, alone I drop and kneel. And I settle, so I held my head up.
Hey, Trev.
I have to go manage some anger.
We have a place where we manage our anger, too. Want to go for a ride?
Should have been dead on a Sunday morning. Take it out. My head right. No time for mourning. We got no time. Should have been dead.
What do you think?
Go ahead. Hurry up.
Excuse me. Excuse me, I'm sorry, I don't know your name.
New girl.
Well, I'm 2 times 22, but you can call me 44. You know, it wouldn't kill you to smile. Listen, I'm sorry about what happened in the rehearsal room. That Brad guy's a demon out on the field, but sometimes he gets a little carried away. I just hope you don't think we're all like that.
Well, I did, but now I don't. Bye.
You know, bye is such an ugly word. I much prefer, like, see you at lunch tomorrow.
No, thank you.
You got a thing against jocks, too?
No, I just never found a reason to wear one.
I'm glad about that. You going to the game on Saturday?
No.
I'll tell you what. You come to the game on Saturday, and I'll go see your play.
Well, that's not fair.
Why's that?
Well, you get culture and refinement, and I get a bunch of roughnecks banging their heads together. Bye.
What's up with this acting thing?
I play this guy who kills his parents and goes into a school and ops 5 of his classmates.
Seems it's all turn beneath
as the party burns.
Let's go!
Come on,
we don't bring just anyone here, so you know.
Oh yeah.
Want a beer?
Place where we can be ourselves. Feels like respect.
I like.
Excuse me. From the top again, Josh with the gun and...
Bang! Love that feeling.
Love it.
Crave it. Need it.
Gotta have a gun grip in your hand.
Always wanted to be an Army Ranger parachuting behind enemy lines ever since I could hold a...
Cap gun.
Water gun.
Air gun.
Pop gun.
BB gun.
12 gauge.
22.
38.
45.
A gun makes you feel alive.
Respect.
Watch out.
Move aside.
What the hell is this? Wrong table, ladies. Time to move, girls. It's the men's table. And you are sitting in my seat. So why don't you and your little freaky friends get up and move? What's your problem, huh? You little freak.
So we don't want
to. What, you want to take us outside?
Yeah. I'm right here.
Yeah.
Take
it.
All right. Come on.
I'm not scared of nothing. Do you want?
You know,
Sean. You. See you.
Sean. That's cool. Let's go, guys.
You guys got to... Nobody can touch you.
When you have a gun.
Nobody mocks you.
When you have a gun.
You can take on anybody.
Anybody.
The champ wrestler.
The whole wrestling team.
The bad dudes.
The gangbangers.
When you have a gun, people talk nice.
When you have a gun,
people look at you like a VIP. You walk different.
When you have a gun,
you talk different.
When you have a gun,
you think different.
When you have a gun,
so cool.
When you have a gun.
It's an A+.
Slam dunk.
Touchdown.
Put down.
All in one.
Love that military stance.
You ain't got a chance.
Respect.
Principal Meyer's office.
Bomb. 2 o'clock.
Watch out.
Move aside.
You can be anything you want to be.
Because a gun in your hand is a PhD.
Yes.
You just met Josh.
For you.
Now you're one of us.
Told you.
Hey Trev, last year were you really gonna blow up the football team? Or was that just talk?
I'm not that kind of person. I've been counseled.
So you really don't know how to make a bomb?
Dangerous?
Only if you stand here. So I cut the wire. Take that. Take the detonator. Put the wire in the detonator. Wash on the car. We're gonna pull the pin. Now I got 2 seconds.
Oh, Jesus!
Jesus. Dying!
Oh! Huh.
Imagine a truck full.
You were seen sitting with the trogs.
Where the firecrackers were found.
Cheering the opposing team. What about the writing on the wall?
Do you know what inducing panic in a public place will fetch? 6 months minimum.
I didn't do it. I don't know who did it. That's all I have to say.
You can go.
Jenny, what happened?
Come on, Trevor. You were sitting right there.
Is your hand okay?
Well, I'm luckier than most. It's only a sprained wrist.
You don't think I had anything to do with it, do you?
I mean, I can't say you didn't warn me. Every day, I take grief from kids for hanging out with you.
Jenny. Jenny. I didn't do it. Okay? I didn't. Stupid.
Trev! You want to go manage some anger?
Ken.
Yeah, let's go.
No, we don't have any leads. Look,
maybe it's a harmless prank, or maybe it's a warning shot across our bow. It might be the perpetrator's crying out for help.
What about the Adams boy? We all know it's him.
No, I'm sorry. We don't know that.
Why take a chance? Boot him out! You have discretionary powers!
We can't take action on suspicion or we will be sued. Our internal security keeps a close watch on all suspicious persons.
What's he have to do before you'll act?
If your security's so good, how'd they get the bullet past the metal detector?
Nothing is 100%.
Does a damn metal detector even work?
This used to be a nice place to live. Now it's just like every other place.
Seems like all education stopped because of one boy.
If anyone has any evidence linking Trevor Adams to anything, they should bring that forward or they should just be quiet.
Mr. Duncan makes an important point.
Speaking of which, what about this bang, bang, I'm gonna kill you?
Bang, bang, you're dead.
Seems there's no control here. Why is a play like that being done?
You couldn't get the rights to Hello, Dolly.
Mr. Duncan.
I'm sorry, but look, has anyone here even bothered to read this play?
That play has been disallowed in this school.
He's doing it at the community theater with high school students. My daughter was in it until I had her yanked out.
Yes, the play's being done on free time, but not on school property.
If nothing is done about this, I'm pulling my kid out of the school.
You're entitled to freedom of expression outside the school grounds, as long as it doesn't reflect poorly on the school. We're not doing anything illegal or immoral.
You might have informed me.
It's a play.
A play that has no answers.
Do you have answers?
A play that stirs up emotions and leaves kids hanging.
Is a metal detector the answer? You put a metal detector in the school, you turn every kid in the school into a suspect.
We don't know what else we can do.
I know you have a hard job, I do. But it's not what's in a kid's backpack that makes him dangerous, it's what's in his heart. This play is the best way I know how to look into a kid's heart.
And I know you mean well, but I must ask you, put this thing off.
You know I won't do that.
Then you leave me no choice but to go before the board and the union.
This school saw fit to ban the play, but the drama teacher thumbed his nose at the school and is now rehearsing the play in the community theater.
That theater receives city support, and we want them tossed out.
If not, we're going to get a lawyer and sue the town.
What gives? Gave us a boot.
All right, this is it.
To do this for the rest of your life. Well, this is it if you get expelled.
Okay, so, boy band versus girl bands, you're right. Sometimes it is hard to tell the difference. Well done. Who's next? Trevor. Okay, now, the rest of you, remember you will be graded on your critiques. I want to see in these critiques objective criteria. Objective criteria. I do not want to see, I think. I feel, or in my opinion.
Yeah.
This is a death threat.
It's a fantasy. It's not real.
You really don't think this is a threat against 32, against Brad?
Yes, in video, but not in fact.
Val, Trevor is still being Trevor.
Come on, Elliot. Don't you think it's possibly being a tad prejudiced?
Why did you show me?
What?
Because you had your own doubts, and rightly so. Val, you're so caught up in who Trevor was, you can't see who he's become. You have to report this.
I've reported it. He's going to see me as another clueless adult in school. I'm on the verge of a breakthrough.
Well, don't ask me if you don't want my opinion.
I didn't say that.
Not in those words. I know you need to do your Quixote thing.
Oh, what's that? Is that a dig?
No, it's a compliment, Val. You're a very high-minded guy, but some people will say you've crossed a professional line.
Tell some people what they call professional. I call sitting up in the bleachers, okay? Tell some people to come down here on the playing field, because it's getting mighty lonely down here.
You mean me?
I don't know who I mean.
I think you do.
You're right.
So did I see this video or not?
What do you mean?
When kids tell their parents and parents start calling the school, I don't want anybody asking me why I didn't report this.
No, you didn't see it. Yes, I'll report it. Thanks for taking the time.
Well, we're out of them now.
We'll get some more by Wednesday.
Hey, Val.
Thespians.
Ah, top of the market.
Savage youth. On stage with all of you. Right, yeah.
Mr. Dean.
Hey, Trevor, can I talk to you for a minute?
Yeah.
Yeah, have a seat. Listen, I had to turn your video over to the principal. I thought it might violate zero tolerance policy. So, giving you a heads up, my airman want to slap your wrist tomorrow morning.
Looking forward.
Hey,
stupid, 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 stupid. I wish someone would take me out of my misery.
Boom!
Who's there?
Boom!
No more pain.
Who said that? You?
Your life is over, Josh.
Over.
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 Dude, in the living room for your parents to see.
What do you mean?
Leave your brains all over the wall.
Make them feel bad.
Shotgun's locked in the closet.
Break the lock.
Boom!
No more pain.
That's dumb.
Only you can make them stop, Josh.
How?
You know.
What do you mean?
Boom!
Whoa!
One bullet would quiet them forever.
You'd end your pain and stop the voices in your head.
I don't want to be thinking this.
Show them who you are. The whole school will stand in awe of you. You'll be a legend for years to come.
Kill the voices, Josh.
Does it hurt?
Bullet in the head? Never feel a thing.
I'm scared. How do I do this?
Make your face a mask.
A mask that hides your face.
Face that hides the pain. A pain that eats your heart.
A heart nobody knows.
Here goes, but suppose I botch it.
You'll be a joke.
Hey, hear about Josh? He tried to off himself, but he blew it.
Now he's a pathetic wannabe forever.
Josh, a joke!
What's the matter?
This is stupid.
Why is it stupid?
I don't know. It's just stupid.
Instead of running around up there, wasting everyone's time, why don't you tell me why it's stupid?
Guy steals my girl. I go totally ballistic. I contemplate suicide. I off my parents. I kill a bunch of kids. It makes no sense.
That made perfect sense to you last year when you made the bomb threat.
I don't know what you mean.
You know exactly what I mean. You made the bomb threat. You endangered lots of kids' lives. You took the first step toward killing.
Anyone die?
Beside the point.
What's the point?
The point is you took that step.
The bomb was empty.
And perfectly made.
Totally harmless.
But most people don't take that step. You did. Now, who's to say you won't take the next step?
It went no further.
Josh did. Josh did. Why? Why, Trevor? What do you have that Josh doesn't have? What do you have that Josh doesn't have, Trevor? Fear of punishment? Conscience? God, perhaps. Ten Commandments? Two chicken? Whatever it is. Let's call it X. Now tell me, Trevor, what would happen if I were to reach right into your soul and remove X?
I'd be Josh.
Yeah. You'd be Josh. Mr. and Mrs. Adams. I'm sorry about this. If there's anything I can do.
Yeah, there is. Don't put her son in any more of your plays.
All due respect, Mr. Adams, I don't think.
Listen, Trevor was on the right track. Then you made him a killer in that play. Then you gave him the assignment to make a movie about a killer. And now here we are.
The assignment was not exactly to make a movie.
Listen, you can split hairs. We don't have that luxury.
I understand how you feel.
You have kids?
No, sir, I don't.
Then you can't understand. Something like this could ruin Trevor's life. So why don't you just stick to teaching and let us raise our son?
Trevor, hey.
Losing business. People won't even come in the store.
People stare at me when I'm in the supermarket. When Lady said I was an unfit
mother. Wouldn't be surprised if you did that firecracker thing.
Always down in your caves.
Ever since you moved down the
street. Always on the internet.
We hardly know you. Grades in the toilet.
Police raiding and searching our home.
What college do you think you're going to get into?
When your brother was your age, he was on the honor roll.
You can try to get the phone.
Trevor, let's talk.
I'm going to bed.
I don't know how to help you.
You can't.
I would know how to help you if I knew what was going on inside your head.
There's nothing you can do.
Do you know where your gun is? Do you want to talk to him before he goes to bed?
What's the use? We've said it all before.
Get a gun from someplace else?
Anything's possible.
Trevor?
Uh-huh.
Am I calling too late?
No.
Was jail terrible?
No, actually. The sandwich was pretty good.
The police called here. They asked me some questions about you. Just dumb stuff.
My parents freaked.
Yeah, well. I made some videos and you're in one or two.
I'm in one or two?
Yeah, I said some stuff.
What stuff?
Well, stuff about you.
Yeah?
Nothing bad.
Are they gonna expel you?
I don't know.
Will you be able to do the play?
Well, Mr. D's the one who turned me in, so.
Why would he do that?
I don't know.
Trevor? Are you okay? Hello? Trevor, what's wrong? Are you okay?
I slipped.
Hello?
Dad, I'm on.
Who are you talking to?
Just a friend.
I know who it is. Say goodbye to him and tell him not to call here anymore.
I'll see you tomorrow.
I'm sorry.
Glad you called.
Me too.
Why would you want to be associated with that troublemaker?
You don't even know him.
Honey, the school doesn't want the play. The town doesn't want the play. Why do you want to do it?
Because I don't let other people make up my mind for me?
You can't reason with her.
You can't do the play, not as long as that kid's in it.
Look who? King of the Trogs.
Hey, King Trogs!
Don't jump in!
It's swirling time!
Stop! Don't!
Stop! Calm down! In you go!
Can't resist a windmill, can you, Quixote?
So, who owns the gun?
Trevor.
Trevor, good guys tell the truth. The gun belongs to somebody underage, right?
You're painting yourself into a corner, Trevor.
What does 32 mean?
It's just a number.
A number that happens to match the football jersey of our varsity running back. Why this animosity between you and Brad Larkin?
I did the assignment.
And what exactly was this assignment?
Here's the assignment sheet.
You'll see that Trevor did exactly what I asked him to.
Well, if he only did what you asked him to, why did you turn him in?
I let the school look at a videotape. That's simply our policy.
That's correct. We expect all teachers to report all kinds of threats.
Why would you put on bang, bang, everyone's dead?
Bang, bang, you're dead.
And you cast a student at risk as the play's killer in a supercharged atmosphere. Didn't you fear you might set him off?
I think when you label a kid at risk, you just created a kid at risk. Trevor gets on stage to play Josh, he faces himself, and that's good. And then when the school needs a scapegoat, Trevor's hauled off down to the office for interrogation. And that, more than any play, is the kind of thing that could set someone off.
Trevor, how do you explain your video?
You've already made up your mind.
Trevor, please. They're only trying to understand.
No kid likes to admit he's being bullied. Makes him feel small in the eyes of his peers. Makes him the little kid who can't stand up for himself. Some kids would rather get beat up every day than to talk about it. So if you really want to get to the truth, call Brad Larkin down here. Ask him to explain how this video came into being.
Brad Larkin's had no part in making this videotape.
Brad Larkin inspired it. He inspired it. Look, everyone in this room needs to face one simple fact, and that is, before last year, Trevor was a model student. Mr. Larkin can tell you how and why that changed.
Mr. Duncan, thank you.
I'd like to see what's on those tapes. We found these among Trevor's possessions. Apparently, he likes to take a video camera to school every day. Let's see what's on that tape first. Why did you take a video camera to school every day?
Same reason you bring a gun to work, to shoot people.
Trevor, just because they cast you as the bad guy doesn't mean you have to play the part.
Look at this piece of trash. What are you doing? Nice camera, you geek. Get out of our school. Suck.
When I'm gone, you'll all have this to ponder and maybe realize why I did what I did. A little push in front of other kids is a very big deal.
Particularly when you know it's going to happen to you every single day.
Every single day.
Every single day.
And you're almost relieved when it actually happens. You're always waiting, waiting for the next attack.
The trash can. Reach puberty yet?
Lick it, lick it, lick it, lick it. Get out!
Lick it. Come on.
They don't just hurt kids, they make you hurt yourself.
Jingle bells. Jingle bells.
Hey!
I can't take two more years of this. And the more they call me the mad bomber, the more they're scaring themselves. They don't know what I'm capable of. They don't know what I can do. And then there's the sanctuary of home.
How many times do I have to tell you
home
to cut the grass?
Okay.
You say okay, but you don't do it.
What's going on?
Is it too much to ask you to spend half an hour cutting the grass?
I said okay.
You say okay, but you're still inside the house. You know how many hours a week I work?
It takes over an hour to cut the grass.
I don't care if it takes 5 hours to cut the grass. Don't you...
Dad, I said I'd cut the grass!
I'll go cut the grass!
All right, so, the play, yes?
Mr. Do-Gooder. Why does he even bother? Doesn't he know it's already too late?
It's creepy, right?
Sometimes I see the way things could have been. I just wish I could be the person she thinks I am. Kids can be the most ruthless people in the world. They can just be supernaturally cruel. Be a man. Be a man. Be a man. days you just want to cry.
You're right.
Sometimes hate is the only real thing in the world.
You can stop loving somebody, but hate seems to go on forever. People respect hate. It speaks, it vibrates.
Hey, man, let me help you out. Okay.
Some people don't even need a gun to hurt you. They use words or laughter. They enjoy watching you bleed to death.
You look like a trash can.
They get off on watching you fighting back the tears, getting a lump in your throat, blushing, wanting to cry. And they give you a name. Trash can.
Pizza face.
Loser. Faggot.
Loser. Weirdo.
Spaz. Retard.
You know, the name does something to you. It changes who you are. It alters your molecules.
And one day you wake up, And you look in the mirror and you don't recognize you anymore because you believe them.
They win, you lose.
You want to cry, please leave me alone, but nobody's listening because nobody cares because you don't have a name anymore because they took it away. And then one day, they say that name and you hear something go snap.
I trust you!
You realize what you got to do. You got to take back your name.
And you've got to do it in front of the whole school because that's where they took your name away from you. You've got to do it.
So every kid will remember.
This is about justice.
And after a while, you can only think of one way.
Jonesboro, Springfield.
Paducah, Columbine.
Gun, a bomb, instant justice.
Ba-bang. But what a rush when they roll out that yellow tape. Miles and miles of yellow tape.
They won't have enough when I'm finished. So when these hallways are flooded with rivers of blood, when these hallways are choked with their corpses in body bags, you will all say, oh, what a tragedy. What a tragedy. But possibly, after viewing my tapes, you won't be so quick to judge. Maybe that's why I was put on this earth.
So consider this my last will and testament.
Okay, let's stop, please. Mr. Duncan, who do you want to call in here?
Hey.
What the hell?
I don't know.
It's totally ridiculous. Bullshit.
I think Meyer wants me.
Everybody gets teased. Verbally or physically?
Both.
Even among friends?
I don't know. Things happen.
What things?
You know, horsing around.
Horsing around?
Yeah, everybody horses around. It's a pecking order.
It's part of school. Did you ever hurt anyone?
No.
No way. What if I said we have videotape of you slamming kids into lockers and shoving their heads into toilets, among other things? Mark, why is there animosity between the football team and Trevor?
I think it started when he got trash canned.
Explain yourself, please.
Last year, there was this spontaneous pep rally in the cafeteria. We had a shot at the state championship, so we wanted everyone to come to the game. Adrenaline was high.
And what would you say, Mark, if I told you that ever since that day, Trevor's life has been a living hell?
I'd say that I feel pretty bad. But I can't say I understand why he feels that way. We never intended to hurt anyone. When upperclassmen trash canned me, yeah, it was embarrassing, humiliating, but it teaches you to get over stuff, and I don't think that's a bad thing.
Who helped you trash can Trevor?
I'd rather not say. But I'll take all responsibility. I'm sorry. I really am.
Dude, don't apologize to him. It was me. In fact, it was my idea. We've all been trash canned. None of us threatened to blow up the school because of it, except for the terrorist over there.
Brad, cool it.
But he is a terrorist. What has he done for this school? We try to bring a little glory to Rivervale, and the terrorist just ruins our reputation. Nobody should be apologizing to him. He's dangerous, and he doesn't belong in this school. So don't make us the bad guys.
Yeah, he's dangerous to the status quo of a school that cares more about kids who make touchdowns and slam dunks than kids who are just trying to make it through the day. I think that Trevor puts on a dangerous act so that kids will leave him alone.
Gentlemen, I will see you all in my office after school to discuss suspension and possible expulsion. Mr. Duncan, I apologize for not hearing you. However, that video is what it is. Trevor, today you have forced us to take a long, hard look at our school. But that does not excuse the fact that you made a death threat which triggers our zero tolerance policy. I have no choice but to expel you. And you should expect a mandatory psychiatric evaluation. Mr. and Mrs. Adams, I'm sure that Police Chief McGee will agree with me that because of the use of the gun, your son will require a lawyer. On a more personal note, this is the most difficult decision that I have ever had to make in school.
I'm gonna get a book from my locker and I'm gonna walk home. Okay? Okay?
Sure.
Hey, Chuck. Is he at rehearsal?
Jump in.
What happened?
You gotta get the hardware past the metal detectors. Tomorrow we hide the guns and backpacks in the trees behind the school.
Lunchtime, Zach. Clog up the men's room toilet. Go get the janitor and bring him there. Right? Then we come in.
Ski masks, right?
No. I want him to see my face. Because Trev's gonna get our story. Trev, you're gonna tell our story and make sure they don't suppress it. All right, Kurt, you go to the janitor's room. Through the janitor's room to the boiler room, there's a door to the outside. And then you let me in. Kurt!
Run!
Run! You should be in the kitchen by now! Go!
gonna drag you through the mud for this. You've been great. But, this is the only way out now. We just want for you to understand that we couldn't let him keep doing that shit to us anymore.
Mommy almost caught me last week. When you saw the gun handle sticking out of my backpack. You believed me when I told you it was the paintball gun. I'm sorry. Dad. What can I say? You said I couldn't do anything right. Just watch the news tomorrow.
Hey, Ma. You don't have to put up with my yelling at you anymore. Finally have peace and quiet. And Dad, wherever you are, I only regret I can't deliver the bullet with your name on it. And we've decided by unanimous vote that we're not going to surrender ourselves.
SWAT team has no choice but you to kill.
Nice three clean shots. I don't want to ever face my parents.
After tomorrow, kids are going to watch what they say. They're going to watch who they push around. All right, that's it. Let's wrap it up.
I love you, Mom and Dad.
They are going to make movies about us.
Yeah. That's it. That's it.
Hello?
Hey, it's me. Am I calling too late?
Yeah, kind of. Mr. D had to cancel rehearsal today. Where were you?
I had a little problem.
Well, you should have called.
You want to skip school with me tomorrow?
Skip school? I don't skip school. I have a test tomorrow. I have class.
We have rehearsal.
Yeah, but I thought we could do something or go somewhere.
What's wrong? I mean, besides everything.
I just want to see you tomorrow.
What, like a date?
Skip school.
Let's do something this weekend.
Jenny, who's calling so late?
Jenny, we gotta get out of here. We gotta get out of here. We gotta get out of here.
Can we talk?
Yeah, sure.
Outside?
Well, why don't we just talk here?
Outside?
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 Come on.
What are you?
Come on.
I don't understand. Are you okay?
Care, man. Care? That's okay.
Go. Go, 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 go.
This car's more trouble. Hey, I'm serious, Squirrely. Let's go. Let's out.
We have to talk.
We will talk at rehearsal, okay? Goodbye. Gone. Hey, no button in line. Out, Squirrely, before I write you up. I will write you up, gentlemen.
Can you get everybody out of here?
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about, Trevor?
Guns. Trucks with guns.
Are they?
Hey,
Everybody, may I have your attention, please? I need an emergency exit to the field doors right now. Let's go.
Whoever's holding this door, let go or you're dead!
Sean!
Trevor?
What's
holding the door?
Me.
What are you doing? Let go, you wrecking me!
Let's go! I need an emergency exit right now! Go!
What the hell are you doing? Let go!
Sean, you gotta give it up! Sean, please put the guns down!
God, put down the guns and listen to me! Damn it! Go! Let go!
Sean, please put the guns down!
Okay. Guns down? They're down, so open the door.
Move.
I can't.
I will.
You helped me when I was down. I'm just returning the favor, Sean.
You're not doing me any favors! You're blowing the whole thing!
You deserve better than this.
Trev, move. I shoot you. I swear to God I will.
Cafeteria is empty. Everyone's gone.
Who's there?
Why me?
Why'd you kill me?
Well, it's more fun than dropping dudes in a video game.
Why me, Josh?
Why not? World's overpopulated. I wanted to do my part.
But you liked me.
Once upon a time.
Why'd you kill me?
I felt like it. Okay?
Why me? I don't even know you.
Wrong place, wrong time.
Why me?
Everybody's gotta die sometime, right?
Why me? I hope I didn't disappoint you in the cafeteria this morning, Josh. I hope I died just right for you.
Some lawyer's gonna get me off. By the time I'm 18, this whole thing's gonna be off my record. You're all just a bad dream.
Sometimes bad dreams come true.
Josh.
Katie, we can go out this coming weekend.
I don't think we should see each other anymore.
Could you give me a second chance?
I like somebody else now.
Sorry I'm late. Oh, hey, Josh.
Him? It's him? I thought we were friends.
Can't we just go?
Body in this class is dead
meet.
We compared the writing on the blackboard to your last essay in English class. It was a perfect match. Our zero tolerance policy gives me no choice but to expel you for the rest of the year.
So because of some stupid words written on the blackboard, I have to repeat the grade?
Not if you go to summer school.
I won't go.
I won't go! You will go.
Sit in a hot class while the kids get to do what they like? Study on summer nights?
You should have thought about that before you wrote on the blackboard.
I'd rather be dead.
You don't really mean that.
You'll see. I'm pushed to my limits.
I think you should calm down.
You know what? I hate you both. And I wish you'd both die so I wouldn't have to look at you anymore.
We tried to give you a good life, Josh. But all we did was feed your appetites.
And starting tomorrow, you have an appointment with a psychotherapist. Bam! Bam!
Mom? Dad? You made me kill you. I wanted to kill you, but I didn't want you dead. I mean, how else can I tell you what's on my mind without you interrupting all the time? I mean, you don't know how hard it is to be no one. Where do I fit in? Mom, where do I fit in? Where can I go where nobody's on my back? I go to school and the teachers give me this test and that paper and do this and don't do that. And then I come home and there's always something I didn't do. And I'm never good enough. I guess I'm just sick of you being disappointed all the time. Dad, do you remember when you bought me the outfielder's glove? I caught that high fly in the Little League championships and you carried me off on your shoulders. Why can't it be more like that? Why is it so easy to talk to you now?
Bang! 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 Bang!
Why'd you shoot me through the heart?
Where do you think you shot me? I hate it when you pretend that I'm not there. My parents don't see me. Kids in school don't see me. It's like I'm invisible.
Why'd you shoot me through the head?
Well, you should have thought of that when you pushed me.
Why me in the stomach?
I had my whole life ahead of me.
So did I.
I've been taught that forgiveness is for the forgiver. But I can't forgive you until I know what was really in your heart, Josh. We want to hear you say it to yourself.
Sometimes I hate being alive, but I'm too afraid to be dead.
You know what I hate about being dead? You can't call up and order pizza.
I miss lying on my bed in the dark and falling asleep to a new CD.
Yeah, I miss getting shot down by girls.
I miss when the guy gets that look in his eye. And you know he's gonna ask you out.
Yeah, right.
Ask to borrow your math book.
I miss my mom's rock-hard brownies.
I miss my dog when I come home from school.
I miss caffeine, huh?
I miss when I take a new pair of jeans into the dressing room and I try them on and they fit perfect.
I miss when you start school and you open a book and the spine cracks.
I miss laughing so hard that I start to cry.
I miss screaming at football
games. I miss being home alone with a microwave bag of popcorn and the remote control in one hand and channel surfing.
I miss my bed.
I miss singing in the shower. I miss getting into a fight with my brother and then acting like nothing happened 5 minutes later.
I miss making my mom laugh so hard she can hardly breathe.
I miss watching the sky go from light to dark.
And dark to light.
I never thought I was taking away all of that. Back of my mind, I thought it was a video game. I could just press the restart button.
What do you know about never? I'll never do all that I wanted to do.
I'll never see all I wanted to see.
I'll never know all I wanted to know.
I'll never have a chance to star on Broadway.
I'll never make my father proud of me.
I'll never find out if that psychic was right.
I'll never see Paris.
I'll never know what it is to come home from work and have all my kids pull me down with their hugs and kisses.
I'll never be married.
And give love.
And get love.
And have a rich, full life.
What do you want from me? I can't bring you back to life. It's over.
Over for us. Josh.
But just the beginning for you.
The rest of your life, you'll have us in your head until you're dead.
And you'll see us over.
And over.
And over.
Again.
As you saw us this afternoon in the school cafeteria.
Dead.
Dead.
Yes.
Dead.
Dead.
I didn't know it was going to be forever. I thought it was just bang, bang, you're dead again. When I killed you, I killed all my possibilities. I will never have anything to look forward to. Never. Is this the rest of my life? Oh, God.
For all the cracks within the frame that I find.